Bound man and put his face in the sand. Not the last mafioso, I'm an MC cop. Got a pinpoint rap that makes you feel trapped. So many girls on my dock, I think my phone is tapped. I'm back, and I'm a soldier at war. I'm making sure you don't try to battle me no more. Got concrete rhymes, been rapping for 10 years. And even when I'm bragging, I'm being sincere. MCs retreat, cause they know I can beat them and eat them in a battle, and the ref won't cheat them. I'm the baddest, taking out all rookies. Get Oreos, eat Kool J cookies. I'm bad.
The sound of LL Cool J, badder and deafer than before. DJ cuts grade out. Bad meaning good.
Who is this guy?
Tim Westwood.
Yes, well, you are the hip hop gangster.
You used to be a big shot.
Kiss FM with me, Tim Westwood, rock shocking that goddamn funky beat.
So tell us about yourself, Tim Westwood.
Well, I'm a club DJ specialising in rap music, and have done for the last 5-6 years. Do some radio as well, do some rap shows on some pirate stations in London. Plus, I've also produced a couple of rap records and various other things.
So, Tim, what are the roots of hip-hop and rap for people who don't know?
Well, it originally started in New York City, in the South Bronx, and eventually the music started to come over here, the scene came over here, and about 5 or 6 years ago, a whole underground scene started in London and other cities throughout the country. And rap evolved through a series of records, through people getting together, becoming graffiti artists, break dancers, body poppers, rappers and scratch mix DJs. And over the last few years, a whole rap scene, a whole big hip-hop scene has emerged in this country. And although rap originally came from New York, the kids there share very similar experiences to people in this country. And if you want to check out the kings of rap, make sure you see Run DMC this weekend at Brixton Academy.
Getting ready. The countdown continues. The beats and rhymes and bass line with me, Tim Westwood. To the TOP tonight, break it. Trouble. Kicking, firing, fighting and singing tonight on the MIC, on the DX. Word, homeboys, make some noise. The deafest jam in town, Run DMC.
I usually know what's going on, and if I'm writing and I'm figuring out what's going on, I might write what's going on.
What sort of messages are Run DMC trying to get across?
Good ones, positive. You know, positive messages, nothing negative, because the kids got enough negative stuff going on without us pulling the negative, because it's a lot of hectic shit out there.
That's the way!
In the crowd tonight, there are some young London rappers, and they wanted to ask your advice on what it takes to become successful.
Oh man, I would say Yeah, I don't know, man. I tell him to rap. Know, you know, go ahead and rap.
Go ahead and make a record,
man. Go ahead
and
do what you can do, man.
Go ahead and,
it's hard to say.
Put it down on tape.
Things I do make me a star. I guess you can be, too, if you know who you are. Put your mind to it, you go real far. The pedal to the metal when you're driving a taxi cab, something, car, something like that. You go fast.
When I first started, I was doing it as a hobby. I didn't think that I'd get fame or anything out of it. I used a normal BSR, the standard deck, just a cheap deck, my mum's turntable, and I used to cut on that. Basically, you're just making music out of other people's records, out of other people's music. The difference between a scratch DJ and a normal DJ. A normal DJ will play the whole of the record, but we'll play the best part of the record, which is the break. We'll keep looping it from deck to deck, from one deck to the other, and make it sound like a record. Scratching is getting a hand on the record and making a rhythmical pattern. And cutting is doing the same thing, putting your hand on a record, but using the fader as well to make a kind of clicking, like cutting sound, clicking sound. You just know what you're looking for out of it. You know the record inside out. When you're cutting up this break, you know what you're doing next. You're thinking about the next tune that's coming on the turntable and what you're gonna do. Usually now, when I'm performing live, I always have the rapper with me, and like I'm doing, just like cutting all the breaks, and he'll be rapping on top of it, and that is really making music out of it.
Before, grab, you want some more? It's like this, the man like DJ Fingers, fresher than ever out the box, and we're gonna have some fun. Check it out. Without my DJ, I can make a crowd scream. My lyrics so divine, a dream is what it seems. But don't think that, cause you're gonna be wrong. I'm in the flesh, homeboy, tall, feel strong, yeah. The mess is bad, looking good and not whack. With super cross lyrics that will make you get flat. So let's get busy on my command. I now declare this party a jam. You ache your mind to figure how I'll do it. You get into it, trust and wanna get down to it. Cause that's my power, when I hold the mic. It's not just maybe, it's what I like. That's why I dominate the rapping division. To stay at the top is my only ambition. So think, homeboy, before you make a stand. Cause I'm the man known who can rock these jams. Like, I love my Kentucky and I love my mum. And if you ask for their fronts, I'll always give you some. Cause what I've designed is the hip-hop lore. Harder you bite is the harder you fall.
Well, I hope it's firing, cause if it's not, I'll be really disappointed. Sipho's just knocking at your back door and you have to let him.
What do you think is happening to the rap scene in London at the moment?
It's getting bigger.
Yeah, it's definitely getting bigger. It started going down when Breaking went out, it all started going down. Now it's coming up again because everybody started to rap, you know what I mean?
Tell me, what's it like being fly girls, home girls in the rap scene?
It's all right, man.
Nothing could be better.
It's like, we don't really think about it, actually. We just get on,
just think about making
If you get on a rap, the crowd can't say, like, they're good for girls. You either can rap or you can't. Do you know what I mean?
Good or you're bad, that's the way we see it, boy or girl.
Dumb
rookie crew tonight.
1, 2, 1, 2. 1, 2. 1, 2.
Remedy.
What?
Remedy.
What?
Tell who we are. We're Cookie Crew on the mic, and we're making most noise.
We get the better of the girls, and that goes for the boys.
We like a place to jam, and we can rock all night,
and then make our way home when the day is bright.
We never shake
when we're threatened or we're under attack.
We never rattle when we battle on the stage and we rap.
Cause we're down to be
the best crew in the world.
We got a beatbox and a DJ, you can bet the old girl.
Now there's nothing in this world could ever take our place.
We're on popular demand at every jam and showcase.
Cause we're D
and Q
controlling
the mic, B girls in our trainers, cause that's what we like.
I think it's good that the Cookie Crew are coming back with their side of the story. And also Salt and Pepper and Jazzy Joyce and that. They're doing real good because there's been this real tendency in rap, especially recently, with like Schoolie D, LL Cool J, Cool Moe D last year. Quite a lot of the guys, the lyrics are really sort of, they exclude the women. They exclude the girls from hip-hop. And like, hip-hop's a really big movement and it's really good stuff, you know, there's some really good beats out there. And I think it's just a bit of a shame if like the rhymes mess it up.
Street Sounds albums, and then started from there. Like, you know, we listened to Run DMC, Sucker MC.
I love that.
Oh,
and
we just used to practice to that. And then Tim got an ex-boyfriend.
No, he's my boyfriend.
And boyfriend got a drum machine, and he started doing drum patterns and that.
Because he was into electro as well,
yeah.
So he went out of his way to get his own drum machine.
Yeah.
And we just started recording tiny raps, and we decided to really get serious with it because loads of people were really interested in what we were doing, and
we thought we'd do it for laugh anyway. It, so. Yeah.
What do you have to do to make a rap record?
Well,
what do you have to do?
First thing I do personally is I set about to just get the rap done. Mm. Then I'll bring it back to the studio, get about in a writing room, start set a pattern on the drum. Mm.
And then I think like, anybody can do it at home even.
Yeah.
You know, like we used to listen to. And just, even if you can't rap,
yeah.
You know, just listen to records over and over again.
Listen to your favourite rap record over
and
over and
practice
learn it.
Over that, you know. It's for you.
We pop out, you know what, you heard us around. Rock steady. What's the timing now? Here is round one. Hot, hot, the beat. Never stop the beat. Hot, hot, the beat. Just rock the beat. Hot, hot, the beat. So funky.
The only, like, hardcore hip I'd hear is on, like, Pirate Station.
Mm.
And, you know, it, like, it's hard to get good records, I reckon, like on Radio 1 or any other station like that. They don't really listen to it. So a lot of people get left out or kicked out. I think it's really hard to get airplay.
Where's my train?
Brothers and sisters, I don't know what this world is coming to.
Yes! The rhythm's a rebel. Without a pause, I'm lowering my level. The hard rhymer, where you never been, I'm in. You want styling? You know it's time again. D, the enemy, telling you to hear it.
Hey, yo, Chuck, man, I love it still.
Hey, yo, you got to slow down, man. You're losing them.
Radio, suckers never play me.
Hip-hop is hip-hop. There's nobody.
Graffiti ain't a separate thing, man. It ain't two things you're into. It's just that scene.
So, like, everything that takes off in New York comes here about a year, 2 years later. But the only thing is with this, you might get other crazies from New York. Whatever it is, graffiti's here to stay. They'll soon accept it as an art form over here, as soon as they find out that they can't control it.
Inspector Williams, British Transport Police. British Transport Police are at the moment are looking into offences of graffiti which have been perpetrated against trains, London Transport trains, not only against the trains but on stations and other property belonging to London Transport. British Transport Police, to combat this, have set up a special squad to look into and to try and combat offences of graffiti. Behind me here you see some of the type of graffiti put onto trains by these youngsters. Some of those, of course, over the age of 16 are adults and certainly should know better. Well, London Transport, usually when a train is heavily graffitied, they take it in and they clean it off so that the public don't actually see the graffiti on it.
They don't want you to see that.
They don't want to run.
That's why when you went to LT office, they showed you all photos of fraps and Polaroid.
Throw up is it's just like letters. Two letters or one letter maybe. Your name and just quickly done with a quick outline. Just gets your name up.
A piece is all colours.
It's a masterpiece of art.
Master outline.
It's just a colourful, your name or whatever, letters.
The colourful. Best art there ever was.
The maddest fusion that could boost their mind.
We're all the same pieces in one big chess game. Yeah. Force of power is in a house. Go take a shower, boy. P.E. our crew, not singular. We wear black wranglers, we're rap stranglers.
If you don't take pictures, then you can't say to another writer, yeah, I done a whole car or I done a panel piece last week.
Plus, when you see your pictures, you can see where you went wrong and that. Mm. So the next time, you get better and better and you learn from your photos.
And this way, we also learn about photography.
Just because a train is stabled inside a yard doesn't mean to say that the electricity is off. Reverse is the case, the electricity is on all the time, and a fall or a stumble could mean that a person could be electrocuted.
You were involved in the street graffiti scene, plus you went to art school. How did the two go together for you?
When I left, in inverted commas, like the graffiti scene as such, to like go to art school, it was a bit of a tough break because I didn't really know on what grounds to actually still produce the same sort of creative work. But I found discipline at art school, which I couldn't have found from like being on the street, as it were. And it's helped me now that I've left, I can use the discipline from the art school to maybe make my work a bit more structured as far as graffiti is concerned. Initially, there was like quite a conflict from both sides, you know, from the art school point of view, there was, the graffiti wasn't really an art form because it had such a negative tag. It was like an uphill struggle for me to sort of like get my work accepted in the same sort of confines as, say, watercolour painting or oil colour painting. I think generally, if you look at the volume of people, young people are actually doing graffiti now, you should take that as a message that people aren't necessarily going to be able to go to art school to produce creative pieces of work, yet they're still producing creative pieces of work in their own environment, and like not see it as just vandalism but maybe a cry from the heart, if you like, that people actually want to produce art. There's a lot of young people all sort of like unemployed. They're not doing nothing. They ain't got no big name. They don't stand out. They're just sort of like in the population sort of thing. Just a number, really. And they want to sort of like point out, get their fame, but sort of like a different way. That's what I'd say the message really is. Just saying that they're alive, you know, that they exist. And to let people know they exist.
Now living in London, you got to have money. Prefer to live somewhere where it's hot and sunny. But as I can't afford it, I gotta stay here, where the natural pastime is drinking beer. Now the rich and the poor, in the north and the south, black and white, these divisions we have to sort out. A divided nation in so many ways, unemployed, can't even afford to take a holiday. Away from the society that's getting rough, can't even take out my girl, I think she's had enough. But it seems she's been infected by material gains. And if that's the way you want it, well go your way, cause there's more to life than just having and holding money and lust for the things that you're beholding. There's caring and sharing and teaching the youth, so stop the nonsense and listen to the truth. See, material pleasure is all that you seek, cause your will is strong but your flesh is weak. Hard drugs, fast living and alcohol, the supplier gets rich while the losers fall. You used to live up north, then you moved down south, but it cost nearly triple just to buy one house. The mere force of hardship and depression caught up, and the knowledge of your mind was all mixed up. You had the picture in your mind of what it would be like. You had plenty of jobs, people being polite, but little did you know it's the same everywhere. If you're rich, you got the attitude of I don't care. Not as we quote all the rhymes we wrote, surely there's a remedy, so don't forget your vote. Do we live in the future? Do we live in the past? We should live in harmony until the mega blast.
Place to be, the almighty MC, cold getting busy, the prince of charm,
Africa Islam, son of Bambada,
cold getting stupid, and you know the man is rocking things out there, Zulu King number one, Tim Westwood, Kiss is stupid, you know it, get busy,
Pirate Radio.
Strictly cheaper, cheaper selection, that is the way we bust it loose tonight. We're not talking worries or trouble, but dealing in murder and distress. The militant selection, fire at will, shoot to kill. Cranking the session to the T.O.P. Cold getting dumb, cold rocking it, cold crushing. Right, I'm out of here, going to collect the London Posse. Strictly for my homie, Bionic and Supersonic with the gold in the mouth. Going round the yard to collect you for the jam tonight. Kiss FM, kicking, firing, biting and stinging. Stand by for Mad Hat and Trevor. With the sound of music, the sound of soul. Bionic, this one's for you. I'll be reaching your yard right now.
Hi, brother. What time are you getting there tonight?
What time do you want me?
Well, it starts at 8:30. So if you could get there about 8.
8 o'clock?
Yeah, no. Not last night.
Yeah, centre. Africa centre.
Any good?
Wicked. Got the adverts queued up?
No, Dave, I'm a bit late with those.
How's your girlfriend?
Bonnet, how you doing, man?
Same.
Yeah, what's been happening?
It's been chilling, you know, yeah. Writing lyrics and that.
Listen, you know your lyrics, like constructive lyrics. Tell us about that, man.
Yeah, well, number one, I do it in my own style. Like, I was a reggae MC before, so I still chat reggae lyrics. And I do it in a rap style, but in a Yardie accent. And I'd use my own Cockney accent. I don't rap in American accent or nothing. Like, that's what's keeping English people back. Rapping in their American accents instead of being English accents.
Yeah, because you were in New York a little while ago, man. Tell us about your time there.
New York, it's bad. It's bad out there. Like, people don't realise, like, over here, hip-hop and hip-hop over there are two different things. When you're over there, you just live in it, because all the people who are into it are there. Like, over here, like, all the freaky people, the people into soul and that, like hip-hop. But over there, it's like ragamuffin, like myself, you know what I mean? Reggae man and that, into hip-hop, you know what I mean? There he is.
Give him a shout, man.
AC!
Nice, Jim.
Yo, AC.
Nice, Jim.
How you doing, man?
Nice, man.
Give me some of that, Jim.
Same.
Yeah, man. Sipho's a human beatbox, man. How you been keeping, man?
Nice, man. Thank you.
Got the drink all over.
Hey, Sipho, brother, we've got the camera in the car with us. So just, like, tell everyone, man, what is beatboxing?
What beatboxing is?
Yeah, man.
Beatboxing, like, is it's a combination of using your throat, your mouth, using your lips, and, like, humming noises and whatever, and, like, creating a bass-type sound with your lips and a snare and, like, as many sounds as you can, and, like, put them into one track beat kind of thing. And, like, with the rapper and with the beatbox, it just sounds like a beat. Like, you don't need the music, you know what I mean? So, there is. There you have it.
Give us some beatbox, man.
Some beats?
Yeah, man.
Just let off a beat, man. Right now, I'm gonna give you my beatbox reggae style. May I flash this style to all concerning, to all those earning and sensi burning. The bionic, the bionic will steal this show, and you'll rock to the beat of my spar Sipho. Cause Sipho is the first, not the second or third. To say that there is better in a London is absurd. So circle and chill, homeboy, and do it now, or I might not go take you out, and this is how. May I go meet you and beat you and wet you. Yes, I will defeat you and your parents will forget you. May I go bury you on a 6 feet underground. You won't even be reported in the lost and found. John all the supersonic, chronic, bionic, deponic. The sound of women fall out of stereophonic. My brethren, I spar with the London Posse. With Sipho, Will Amaze, Will Rock and Rock Roddy. The London Posse, stinging and shocking. Long with Stewie Rankin, and you know that he is singing and rocking. The crowd in all the dance, entertained by my DJ business. They're on the decks with a Wally for DJ Critics. Special requests for the rest, stuck on the masses. But they're not easy rocks, I know them don't pass it. The Fly Gal Posse, just bubble for me, the bad boy posse, then just fit on MC. Why on it, pon a mic, him just fit right the MC. Now dedicate themselves to each and everybody. Come kick my beatbox reggae style. Sipho with the beat, me with the yard style verse, and I'm proud to say to the crowd, we were the first. But one upon the mic, and flash them style right. If all no traffic, cause we'll end is also I'll go fight you down. Giving you the beat is the living you need. My spark or Sipho will rock you with his beatbox. Two bar leads, we don't have no dreadlocks. Sipho rocks, and Sipho I said rocks. No, I'm a spar, run, come catch through fame. And tell a crowd of people in a dance your name.
Sipho, my posse's giving a show, and we want y'all to know.
Can I have everyone's attention, please? The time has come to introduce our last act on stage tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, the London Posse!
Ace! This is hip-hop reggae! Same. Wrong come catch a reggae
with the hip hop mix
on the way to 42nd.
We was on 46.
Then we ran into these birds
on the way to the Rick.
Spoke a few
words, they was on our tricks.
So we smoking with the swords,
getting high
while smoking.
Stopped on the corner,
skin a spliff,
started talking.
On the posse, we don't joke, we don't smoke, speed or coke. On the Charlie or GoPro, my fair lady,
easy man,
fine, fine.
Where the Union Square.
Fuck up on two gals.
You made a stop and stare.
First we
clocked them, stopped them. We asked them where
the square was.
And the sweet dude flogged up, took his dick.
So I phoned on man on the phone. I told my gal you should've saw it.
It's going on as if they fought England. What's for your story?
Thought that you was every you in England was the South. But when she heard the creep club, I just loved the way I stood.
We are the London Posse.
Yes, y'all know we are the
London Posse.
Lord of God, we are the London Posse.
Go on. London Posse. That is the way you throw rock.
Getting ready to crank the session to the TOP tonight. Eric B to the highest degree. It's time to get goddamn busy tonight. Strictly the people's choice.
Strictly the power play, come rocking it.
Thinking of this, you keep repeating your miss. The rhyme from the microphone solo with. So you sit by the radio,
go rockin' the jam.
And dial soon as you hear it, pump up the volume. Dance with the speaker till you hear it blow. Then plug in a headphone, cause here it go. It's a four-letter word when it's heard to control your body to dance. So, dot text the tempo like a red alert.
Eric B to the highest degree and quality. Go rockin' out of the gangster boogie with me, Tim Westwood, Man out of Trevor, together forever, tougher than leather.
The rhyme will go deaf with the record that was missed a long time ago.
It ain't where you're from, it's where you're at. You got it, we know it. The breaks of the beat sound bassline, goddamn.
I was in when I'm writing, I'm trapped in between the line. I escape when I finish the rhyme. I got soul,
soul, soul. Strictly the militant selection, armed and dangerous. That is the